so excited to introduce to you today Laurie Zagon, who is the founder and the executive director of Art and Creativity for Healing, who has helped over 80,000 people in our community receive hope and healing through art. Laurie, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thanks for having me. I'm excited to be
here. It's a pleasure. Whenever I think of art, I think color, happiness, expression. Can you give us a little bit of an overview of what you do?
Sure. I think the most important thing is that color can be a language for people, mm-hmm. and it transcends ethnicity mm-hmm. and other languages. Mm-hmm. So what happens is, like, when people take our classes, they have a tendency to come in and feel intimidated. It's art. Oh, I'm not good at this.
What if I've never painted?
Right.
Exactly.
Right.
And we come in and we lay out the white canvases and we take them through some warm-up exercises, mm-hmm. like, for instance, like a word and saying, like, close your eyes, take a deep breath and relax, mm-hmm. and express the feeling of lonely.
Yeah.
And 20 seconds to do it, pick a color. Mm-hmm. And they'll put a little abstract squiggle or stroke in a box, mm-hmm. and then they'll share about it, some of them will, and say, oh, I use black because, and that little dot was because when I'm lonely, I feel isolated and alone and small.
Interesting. And so what does that help these people do? Is it just like a stimulation for communication, or is there something magical about the way the art and the communication work together?
It actually gives pain a voice.
Hmm.
And that's one of the things that I love about it so much, because I'm not a therapist, nor any of my facilitators. We're all fine art facilitators.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody that teaches for us is a guide to just guide people through the process. And so what happens is that they are people coming in that are going through some of life's adversities, you know, mm-hmm. whether it be they've lost a loved one, or they've lost a job, or they're going through divorce, whatever it is. And then, of course, we also work with children that are going through a divorced mm-hmm. set of parents or mm-hmm. whatever. And so we're just creating a space that's safe and comfortable for them mm-hmm. to express themselves. And they don't realize how deep they're going to go until the colors start popping out of them.
Interesting.
And then they'll put it up and say, oh my goodness, I thought of something from 20 years ago and I can't believe that that's what I painted about.
Wow, so it can help stir up some of these long-term memories as well.
Yes, and I must add, though, that we do recommend that they see a counselor or therapist if things are needed to work on that are more psychological, emotional, and we usually have a list of local therapists that we can send mm-hmm. them to, but most of the people we work with are seeing counselors.
Mm-hmm. That's very interesting. So let's say that, because this is a real-world example, okay? So I'm having some difficulty at my day job. I feel isolated. I feel like I'm having trouble communicating with some of my peers. And so let's say I go in and I want to have some therapy, some art as therapy. So what would you do for me? I would come into a community center, or?
Well, our studio is right on Molten and Lake Forest.
Okay, into Molten and Lake Forest.
Right.
Okay.
And so I just had a group just 3 days ago, and I probably could say, but I better not, just in case, because it's a corporate group. I do a lot of corporate workshops.
Okay.
So for people like you're talking uh-huh. about, and they come in and they want to have a team building workshop.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll do something called Art for Renewal and Stress Management.
Mm.
And we will do some things
like
I mentioned. And it's great with a group that all work together, because it's a uh-huh. great way to get to know people and know more about them when they're painting and what they're sharing. And it was very revealing the other day with this corporate group, because they were all really happy to work together except for one
mm.
who seemed ready to probably go somewhere else.
Yeah.
And you could just sense that by the way that person isolated themselves mm-hmm. in the conversations that they were all having about the art.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't know. I mean, sometimes it works really, really well, and other times it's probably going to reveal some things that people don't realize are coming from them by the way they're sharing.
Yeah.
Is it only groups, or can individuals sign up and participate?
I only work with groups.
Okay.
We don't do one-on-one at all.
Mm-hmm.
And the group dynamic is what makes it so fabulous, mm. because the shy person who's going to paint and not want to share is anxious to hear what the other people are saying when they're sharing.
Interesting.
Because it just triggers them into thinking, like, oh wow, that's happened to me too, or I feel that way.
Mm.
Oh, that my painting has that pink in it, and that's what it meant for me. So mm-hmm. that type of thing is a way to help people come out of their shell a little bit about sharing.
So you're in a way naming emotions through color.
They are.
That's
they
very
are.
Interesting.
Because what a purple, you know, color is to one person, that it means spiritual for somebody. Mm. Right. To another person, it's a funeral color from their ethnic background.
Interesting. Right.
And to other people, it might be a bad memory because that was the color of their mother's kitchen growing up.
Exactly.
That's right.
So many associations. That's
and we
right.
get that. I mean, the amount of sharing is extraordinary. I mean, one of the things that happens, we work with Camp Pendleton Marines mm-hmm. and Wounded Warriors. So we've been going there for the last 12 years. Mm-hmm. And what they share is so amazing. When we first go in there, they're, you know, big, burly, well, men and women, but the big, burly guys. And they're like, what are we doing? I don't paint. Like, what is this about? And they sit down.
I can totally see. They're like, yeah. I can't really yeah. get my
Yeah. And they sit down and they start doing it. And they just become those five-year-olds. That's where, going back to the Wall Street,
right. That's really
which I'll
nice.
Tell you about. But with them, they get so into it. And then they start talking about, like, the red here is my buddies getting blown up in Afghanistan. Uh-huh. Or the black is like the black smoke from the bombings and mm-hmm. things. So they really get a chance to say things. And the therapists on base who bring us in, they say, wow, they would not talk to us at all until they took your class and
wow.
showed us the paintings
wow.
and then opened up. So we feel good about that, except that we're not privy to all that information.
Right.
I wish I knew how it ends later, but
yeah. But you know it's doing good
but
because
you know.
They keep inviting you back.
They do, and 12 years, I guess, so,
and to
yeah.
hear that, where it opens them up and makes them ready to
yes.
be able to address some things. You mentioned the Wall Street story.
Yes.
Can you give us a little more
sure.
explanation about that?
I'm a New Yorker, and so when I came out to California back in 89, so it's a long time ago now, but before, I was 14 years as a university professor of art at the City University of New York, and I was teaching painting, design, and color theory. So color resonated with me mm-hmm. early on. Mm-hmm. I always loved it, and I always felt that it was my own personal way of coming from a dysfunctional family in Flushing, Queens, where I stayed in the basement and painted mm-hmm. because things were a little too crazy upstairs.
Right.
And it really helped me as a child. So for me, this really ties into why I started the nonprofit.
Got it.
But with Wall Street, it was interesting because a couple of guys from Wall Street came to my studio to look at mm-hmm. my paintings, and they asked me about, could I teach a class for them? And I said, well, what could I possibly teach you? And they said, well, can't we just come and mess up a canvas one night? And I went, oh, what a great idea. I think we should do that. And so that really became an art and stress thing for executives.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah.
Highly necessary.
Very much. And mm-hmm. also, those were no phones in those days, except
yeah.
for those giant Wall Street 2 movie mm-hmm. phones.
Right?
But they didn't have those with them. So they were tapping those Rolex watches, like, how long is this going to take? And I got to get up early. And then mm-hmm. market opens really early. And I was like, whoa. So when they first came in, they marched in Armani suits, like mm-hmm. the super expensive suits. You don't want to get paint on those suits. Mm-hmm. But they came in, and I was like, we're going to be painting. And I did have aprons, but still, you know, it was still, like, scary, because I don't know what they'd do to me if they marked up those suits. And so when they sat down and started painting, and I saw the change in them 20
yeah.
minutes later, five-year-olds painting, jackets were off, they were into it. And the VP of Goldman Sachs calls me over and says, where's the painting you said was good when you reviewed the paintings? And I said, oh, it's over there, it's drying. And he said, don't let anything happen to it because I got to get it to the framer tomorrow. He was getting it framed.
Oh,
it was just poster
gosh.
Paint and paper. It meant that much
yeah.
to him.
That's amazing.
That's
so I knew I was onto something then.
Yes.
But I knew that I wanted to work with people. At that point, I knew that I wanted the wounded children, and I wanted mm-hmm. people that had suffered from trauma, because I was one of those people.
Yes.
So I knew that I needed to move forth with that, and I was fortunate enough to meet Dr. Claudia Black, who is famous for working in the field of addiction.
Uh-huh.
At the time, she lived in Laguna, and she and I collaborated on a book together called It's Never Too Late to Have a Happy Childhood, Inspirations for Inner Healing, and it was my paintings and her inspirational sayings.
That is beautiful.
Yeah.
And she introduced me to all her therapist friends. She had every single friend except me. I was the only artist friend. But they were all therapists, and they all wanted me to do workshops for their groups. And that's how it started.
Oh,
it was just
wonderful.
Like working with cancer patients, working with seniors,
mm-hmm.
working with addicts that were in 30-day treatment, all of that. And that's how it started. It was before the nonprofit, though, because, you know, I didn't really know I wanted to do a nonprofit until
sure.
I kept
mm-hmm.
doing it.
Mm-hmm. And so it's how many years now that
it's
you've been
19.
Doing this? And I know you have a gala coming up, and yes. I want to make sure we can share that information with our viewers.
Once a year, we do a big fundraiser, because our programs are free to the community. So when we go to all these locations for all the different groups, we raise funds. And so this gala coming up is on October 12th, mm-hmm. and it's nearby. It's in Irvine, but it's kind of Irvine Lake Forest, right mm-hmm. off yeah. the corner. And it's called AV Irvine. So that stands for Audiovisual Irvine. Oh. Big, wonderful building, state-of-the-art, and we take it over, and it's going to be a Monte Carlo casino night. We have 200 silent auction items. We have a lot of artists donating art, and it's a way for us to raise 20% of our budget so we can give more out in the community.
That's wonderful.
That is wonderful, and I love what you were, just to kind of bring it all back, I love that you are giving people a voice who are not very verbal
right.
and able to share it in that way. You're tapping into a huge group of people and offering
Thank
them
you.
That healing.
And you also have a grant that you just received
yes,
for a
I
very specific purpose.
You know, I'm so excited. We're working with Southern California Hospice Foundation as a partner. Wonderful organization. And we're partnering with them, and we received a grant so that we can do workshops for families that have lost a loved one. Mm. So what I want people to know out in the community, it's free. It's mm-hmm. a 4-week session where you get to celebrate the lost loved one, mm-hmm. doing a collage and painting, but it's really about celebrating the person you've mm-hmm. lost. And normally it would cost, you know, probably, you know, a couple hundred dollars, but it's free. Mm-hmm. So those that are interested, contact us on www.artforhealing.org. And we will be able to send you something for you to sign up if you're mm-hmm. interested. Some okay. of them will be at our studio here, and the others will be located in other areas in Orange County. Mm.
And that website is good for all information.
Everything okay. that you want to know, the gala, everything, classes. Yeah.
Wonderful. Perfect. Well, thank you so much
you're
for coming
welcome.
On
Thanks
the
for
show
having
today.
Me.
This
and
was
congratulations.
So
this
thank
is
you.
Really tremendous.
That's
thank
right.
Thank you for sharing.
Thank you. We'll be right back.